Hello ma'am, my name is Dhaval Pandav. I am from collegejourney.com. A very warm welcome to our interview series, which is called Thoughts on Education, where we interview with the BDS dignitaries such as owners, VCs, principals, HODs and teachers. Before I proceed with this interview, I would request you to give a brief introduction about yourself, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Mrs. Sai Savant. I'm heading examination department in SLRPDC. And I have experience of 9 years, and I have worked as an assistant professor as well as coordinator of PMS department. My dedication, my commitment to the institution will definitely lead to the success of the institution as well as my professional career.
It was really nice knowing about you and your experience, ma'am. So my first question is, you have held a key position at Education Institute throughout your professional career, ma'am. So what keeps you connected with the education sector, ma'am? And how has been your experience so far with this institute?
Speaking about connection with the education, teaching is my passion and fashion. I like students around me. And this is only one reason why I'm connected to the process.
Being the HOD at SLRPDC, what are your roles and responsibilities toward the students?
I have already mentioned that I am heading examination department of SLRPDC, which is a crucial department. And my role and responsibility is ensuring smooth and fair conduct of examination, which covers scheduling of the examination, orientation to the faculties, guidance to the students about the rules and regulations, and most importantly, avoiding unfair practices.
Can you tell us about a few extracurricular activities at SLRPDC?
Extracurricular activities, our students are engaged in n number of activities, n number. If I'll speak about the cultural, n number of students are there, and we have won lot of awards, many awards this year. The very recent award we have won from Bant Singh College, Kurla, as the best college award. And n number of activities are carried out under NSS and DLNE team, where students are engaged with community service. Recently, we have went to the camp, NSS camp, where students have served the village called as Kasarli village, and they were stayed there for 7 days, and they have served the people there with the beach cleaning activities and teaching to the school students, playing with them, imbibing values in them, mannerism, all these things. Our students are really engaged with all these things, and their personal development is.
How do you try to bring practical approach towards the subjects and make it industry oriented?
Practical approach towards the subject, basically I teach management, and in management we can have lot of management games. So recently only I have conducted one activity for that particular subject, which is called as principle of management. The logo, or the I can say the slogan for that particular activity, was breaking the four walls. That means instead of taking a class in these four walls, I have taken them to the ground, and I have conducted management activities which includes coordination, which include leadership skills. And the students were like, really they have broke the walls.
How do you, what do you see as the greatest strength of SLRPDC?
Greatest strength of SLRPDC, the first thing I have to mention is that it's multi-generational management team, where three generations they are working together to lead the institution, which is very, very, I can say, unique, which brings uniqueness and innovation to the college. If I speak about our Honorable Chairman, sir, he is there. He's under his guidance, college is running. Along with him, his wife, our President, ma'am. Then our Secretary, Shri Rahul, sir. Joint Secretary Shri Krishna Madam, and last but not the least, our COO Mr. Utsav Tiwari. So I can say there is a combination of experience, skills, which all these three generations, under the vision of all these three generations, the college is getting a unique identity. They are thinking from different perspectives. They have different skills, they have different experience, and with the new generation they have fresh ideas also. So all these things makes a college a unique institution.
Any suggestion you would like to give to the current youth and aspiring students?
For the youth, I would suggest that keep learning. Continuous learning is very, very important in your life. It's not just you have done your MCOM, you have done your PhD, it's not enough. You have to learn from the experiences, and you need to have one mentor. You need to have one mentor who will navigate you to achieve your goals.
It was a pleasure talking to you and interviewing your thoughts on education, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.